Another question that one of our readers sent in. This is a good question. This actually comes up a lot. Is it bad to mix standard oil with synthetic? Say you have standard oil in your tank and you need to top it off. Is it bad to add synthetic to that or vice versa?
It's a myth. Semi-synthetic, like this, the Spectro 2050, is a blend of mineral oil and synthetic oil.
Okay.
So it's perfectly okay to mix them together. That's how semi-synthetic is made, by mixing a mineral oil and a synthetic oil.
Okay.
So it's fine.
So it's okay. The next question that came in, if somebody does an oil change and they have synthetic oil, and then their next oil change, is it okay to use standard oil?
That's another myth. It's perfectly okay to switch back and forth. However, you should stay with the brand that you're using.
Okay.
So if you're using Spectro synthetic, you want to switch to Spectro mineral oil, that's okay. I wouldn't switch brands regardless of what you're doing. You know, keep switching back and forth. Most oils are compatible. However, manufacturers use different ingredients. Sometimes they're not so compatible together, and you may end up with mild sludging or foaming until it all gets worked through the system. So try to stay with the same brand.
Gotcha.
If you're switching oil, but it's perfectly okay to switch back and forth.
So if you're in a jam, you're out on the road and you're down, you need to add like a half a quart, and all you have is a standard and you've got synthetic, it's okay to add that to
it. It's okay, absolutely.
It's a lot better than leaving nothing.
Absolutely, yeah. Yes, any oil is better than no oil.
Gotcha. Great. Well, those are the questions that came in. Our readers, I'm glad that we were able to get answers direct from Roland from Spectro. Thanks for that.
You're welcome.
And is there anything else we need to know about Spectro? You guys have like some racers you're sponsoring that we need to look out for?
Yeah, we have some racers out there. We have a couple of new ones we haven't announced yet in drag racing. We're working with Doug Foley and the DOAT NHRA Top Fuel team.
Sweet.
This year, so that's really kind of exciting for us. We have some of our road racers are back again this year. We have quite a few amateurs in New England and the rest of the country that we help too. So we have a very strong grassroots program, and we help amateur racers out. And,
great.
Difficult for those guys to get support, so we try to help them out.
Well, you guys will keep Garage Girls on top of that. You'll send us information. We'll put it up on the website for you guys so you can check out what they're doing and help support those guys out there racing.
Absolutely. Also, look for our monster trucks. We have two monster trucks.
No way! Awesome.
King Crunch and...
King Crunch
and El Matador. So check them out. They're on Monster Jam on TV.
Awesome.
And they're coming to a city near you. So they're running Spectro. They're loving the product in it. And the abuse those trucks take is
no kidding,
is
huh?
Amazing.
Yeah.
You know, they're blown, injected alcohol motors.
They're insane.
They're insane. They're like 1,500 horsepower. And, you know, they beat them to death. But they're loving the product. And we love having them on board. So
awesome. Really, that's so great. Cool. All right. Thanks so much, Roland.
Thank you for stopping in, Sarah.
All right, cool.